Hi everyone, Oskar Świerat here. Welcome to the new tutorial about graphics profiling in Unreal Engine 4. What was meant to be a single video ended up being four separate videos, so let me go through a kind of a table of contents. The first part covers ways to measure performance in a professional, predictable way. I will show you how you can measure with milliseconds instead of FPS, and what are the basic console commands for statistics. Here you can see scene rendering statistic that can count your dynamic lights, the cost of translucency and the amount of draw calls. I will go through all the basic necessary stat commands in Unreal. The second part covers the graphics pipeline, so how a modern GPU works, what pixel, vertex and memory related issues you can expect and how to find them. And I will also show you optimization view modes. For example, here you can see a quad overdraw mode, which shows an issue that is not quite known among artists, I think, but it's very important when preparing your static meshes. Part 3 will be the introduction to profiling. I will cover the entire process of profiling your scene within the Unreal Engine. So I will use the GPU visualizer tool and explain all the passes that Unreal rendering pipeline consists of. With this tool, we will be able to find, for example, what shadowed lights have the biggest cost, or how exactly big is the cost of post-processing in our scene. And the final part 4 will explain external profiling. I will use a tool from Intel that allows to capture a single frame from within the game and perform very detailed profiling of this particular frame, down to the cost of a single light, even if it is not shadowed, and the heaviness of particular meshes, which you can be able to find by name here, or just visually. And we will test various scenarios. For example, how our game performs when we disable all textures. In this way, we will be able to find the bottlenecks very precisely. This could affect how you prepare your content, how many things of specific kinds you place in your scenes, and how to reach the desired target of frames per second. If you are not watching from a playlist, then please find the links to the particular movies in the description. So thank you for watching the introduction, and let's proceed to part 1.